My great grandfather was at Pearl Harbor, and a lot of my family has given up, you know, has gone and fought in wars, and I really haven't done a damn thing as far as laying myself on the line like that. And so I have a great deal of respect for those that have and what the flag stands for.
Who does this? Who takes a perfectly perfect life and ruins it? A perfectly happy wife and marriage and jeopardizes it? Ah! If I do not strangle someone while I'm here, I was touched by an angel.
Tillman and Marie were married only a few days when he enlisted. By July 2002, married just 2 months, he was in boot camp.
As always, Marie is on my mind. I've been unable to speak with her since we've been here, and I miss the sound of her voice.
Pat and his brother Kevin enlisted together and served together in the elite Army Rangers. Their platoon mates remember them as inseparable.
If Kevin and I are part of a situation where we must fight, every bit of my soul knows we will fight as hard as anyone ever has. We will not question the reasons for our being here or allow any personal beliefs to interfere with our job. My hope is that decisions are being made with the same good faith that Kevin and I aim to display. I hope this war is about more than oil, money, and power. I doubt that it is.
He made the call. He dismounted his troops, taking the fight to the enemy uphill to seize the tactical high ground from the enemy. He directly saved their lives with that move. Pat sacrificed himself so his brothers could live.
Pat asked me basically what was going on, and I let him know. And it didn't take long before those in the GMV who were stopped at the time to dismount and open up on us with the 50 caliber machine gun and the 240 Bravo machine gun, and basically shot at us in waves or bursts of rounds. At that time, I felt myself become limp, and I got down. I had no cover, and there was nothing blocking my sight between the people at the Humvee shooting at us. I know Pat had basically was able to get himself behind some cover, but it was not much. I basically was yelling, waving from on the ground as much as I could, and I believe Pat was too at the time because he was behind me. And talking to him, yelling, screaming, trying to figure what was going on when he told me he had a plan, and he, at the time I thought, popped a pen gun flare, you know, to signal the troops down in the GMV that we were friendlies, but I later discovered he had popped a smoke grenade. And after he had done that, the firing ceased in the truck. So we had both believed at that time that the shooting was over and that they had recognized us as friendlies. And we both stood up, faced each other, was kind of wondering, hey, what just happened there? Wow, it was an accident, you know. Luckily, we're both still alive. It didn't take long after that, sir, before they moved into a better position, as I said, in the GMV, and started shooting at us again. And at that time, both of us had gotten down. I was watching them do that, and I could hear Pat calling, "Stop shooting, Pat Evan Tillman. Stop shooting," you know, over and over and over again. And I could hear the pain that he had in his voice. So I had known that he was hurt at that time. And it abruptly stopped with him calling for help.
And I remember him, he was trying to make contact. He was waving his arms and everything.
Pat and an Afghan soldier serving with him were killed by friendly fire.
I saw him slumped over. I saw O'Neill grab him and pull him back. And that's when I could tell he was hit. Couldn't see it great. In all honesty, I didn't really want to look at it. It's a lot of, I've never seen a whole, it's looked like a mist of red.
I will remember that his family and his country lost a good man. And I will celebrate the brief, brave, and happy life of Pat Tillman.